Today, I want to finally share the video about making your own shimmery alcohol inks. So if you have some alcohol inks or even alcohol ink markers, you could use the ink from that. And then you need at least the 91% rubbing alcohol or isopropyl alcohol and some bottles. I have a range of squirt bottles that I'm going to talk about as well. So a bit of a review on that, as well as the Ranger Pearl inks.
Okay, I want to share with you a little bit about the DIY Pearl alcohol inks. Now, if you're waiting to, say, purchase the Adirondack Pearls, which are alcohol inks with mica powder in them, you can do your own. Now, of course, the formula may not be exactly the same, but I've tested it out by squirting it onto the surface, like the Adirondack or Ranger ones, and I find that they dry with the mica powder. I don't know if you can, yeah, see that? That's the mica powder settled into the bottom. I'm going to show you a few different bottles, too, that I've tried to use as DIY alcohol ink, whether you want to make your own colors, whether you want to extend it into 99% or 91, anything not over 90% isopropyl alcohol or rubbing alcohol. That can actually add to your strongly pigmented inks like Pinata or some of the strongly pigmented other inks that you can get. And then you can make a paler color. But if you want that shimmer, and I got this idea when I was working on this table, see how colorful, I wouldn't even go there, it's just a, I got the idea where I thought, man, can I make my own? Because what I found that happened when I used the Ranger one is that the pigment or the ink, the mica powder that I heard was made especially for each color was actually a lot lighter. So when the ink evaporated and your pigment for your ink was left, you would have like a powdery, it was shimmery. It's shimmery, no doubt. However, it is paler than the ink, like significantly paler. Now, if I'm using colors to say color this table or make mini galaxies like I am doing over here and I've been trying to work on lately, I would like it to be more true to the color. That the shimmer, is going to not totally change the color. Once it evaporates, I'm going to end up with a powdery white or very pale pigment. So something like this. Okay, so here I added, it's kind of a burnt red, I think it was blue russet, and a little bit of a matching color ink combination, which looks like it possibly a bit of red, a bit of yellow. I have so many colors. I am not very good at keeping color recipes. I just kind of wing it. As an artist, I don't really record. I'm not as scientific about things, so I don't really record how did I get that color. So just play around. These bottles are the best. I got these at Amazon. And I will hopefully remember to put links at heartfullycreating.blogspot.com or below so you can find some of the good ones because it really makes a difference. These needle tip applicator bottles with a little rubber cover, frankly, I don't even need them. I could tip them over. They don't leak really unless I smash them or drop them, then they might squirt. But again, if you get alcohol ink on your white ceramic tile, like I have many times, we know that rubbing alcohol will get that off. So these were very inexpensive, and I really, really like them. And you can draw with these tips. Like, it's pretty cool. So that's a lot easier to use. And this one, too. So far, I haven't had any problems with these ones. These I got from eBay. And when you screw the lid off, I'm trying to do this with one hand because I'm using the camera with the other hand. Never a smart thing to do. Anyway, I can't get that off right now, but let me try this one. And then the other one that here's one that I used where I just want to have more of a silver effect. So see all the pigment? I put a lot of silver, different silvers actually in the bottom, more of a chrome nail art powder, still using nail art powders a lot. And then just put it, oh, here we go. So this bottle came, I got 5 in a set from eBay with free shipping. Didn't take long to arrive, and they have these plastic, I had to get my husband to put it back on, but these plastic tips that pop in, and they're very, very sealed. So my husband had to push very, very hard to get that to seal. So yeah, there's no leaking when I squeeze the bottle, and there goes the lid on the floor. That's pretty normal for Anita. So I'm going to shake it. So you do have to shake, Now, of course, with the Adirondack and pearl inks and things like that, and the metallic fixatives and stuff like that, they do have a white metal ball inside to help with the shaking. But if you shake and shake and shake, I'll bang it and things like that to get it to flow and get the powder back into the alcohol mixture. Okay, and then all you do is just squirt, and you could like draw. It's really neat. And then when you let it dry, this is very watered down. I only wanted the shimmer effect, so I only have the silver. But then this brighter color, I did get a mica powder that is closer to the ink color. Now that's really important if you don't want it to dry like the Ranger pearls do, because they're a lot lighter. If you look at, you can tell just by looking at what's settled in the bottom, just how light it is. So here, just really like, yeah, just kind of give it a squirt. You can't really see it yet, but it's very, I have these more like watercolor effect inks. I don't want the strong pigment, but I do want the pearlescent effect, which I didn't shake very well. But anyway, it does work. It really does. Now, my biggest pet peeve bottle is by the company called Daris. But right now, I'm going to show you these ones. These are another set of bottles I got. These are a little more expensive. Again, don't have to even worry about putting these. Actually, didn't come even with a lid. They come with like a ball tip pin, straight pin to sit inside. I don't even use that. It doesn't. They don't dry out. The tips don't ever get clogged. Again, see the powder at the bottom. So I just made that on my own. I can shake and shake and shake. I love these bottles. Again, anything that it makes it easy to kind of like draw with no leaking. What really drives me nuts is bottles that leak out the sides around the neck of the bottle. No matter how tight I seem to, sorry about that. No matter how tight I seem to put it, the bottle, it just squeezes. It's so messy. That's when you're really wishing you wore gloves. But what happened with the Daris bottles, I'll tell you in a second. It was a big mess. So look at how bold that yellow is. And then what I do, because that's got the pigment powder, and I just want to create more of a layering or glazing effect, which is not a solid color over top. I want to see the other colors through it. So I just kind of dab with my finger. Of course, use gloves because you'll end up, with stained fingers. It's up to you. I like to feel what I'm doing. So yeah, and on this little mini galaxy, I've actually been using glitter. Polyurethane actually has been my medium of choice lately. It just seems, I don't know, easy to access. And then here's the my biggest, messiest, pet peeviest bottles ever. I thought they'd be great because I saw somebody else at another great channel using alcohol inks with resin and stuff, and she seemed to always be using these long tipped bottles, and I just assumed it was these ones. Well, I bet you it isn't, because these are a nightmare. Well, of course, nightmares are worse. No matter how tight I put it, no matter what, I don't want to even experiment, because I pretty much got rid of all the ones that were the worst, which was at least half of what I purchased. And it just runs, and you could see the seam. If there's a thick seam like this around a bottle, the odds are pretty good that it's not making a very good seal around the neck. So cheaper, these were, I mean, they were maybe $5 for six bottles, I think. It wasn't super bad, but I definitely had big expectations. And there you can see the mica powder again. It might look white, but it's not. It's like a pale blue. So I can use this bottle. I don't think it leaks, because I'm pretty sure I got rid of most of them, because the mess is horrendous. It's nothing more kind of, well, there's, I must stop using that expression. Nothing more disappointing than having a bottle leak when you're using it. There's, of course, many more disappointing things than that. But see, I'm not even squeezing. I'm just letting it flow out. So this one, because the tip is a bit thicker, it just actually flows. I'm just not even squeezing. So thankfully, if I don't squeeze, it shouldn't leak out the side. But some of them, oh man, what a mess. So just really keep an eye on these. I did complain to the company. I don't think I got my money back, but I just wanted people to know, because just be careful. But yeah, so these ones without the needle tip, metal needle tips, they seem to work well. Again, I'll provide links at myheartfullycreating.blogspot.com. And the needle tips are the bestest. So just because you get more control and more drawing ability. So, and yes, and I do actually use a small, one of my very first favorite needle tip bottles that are a bit more expensive, like the yellow one I just showed you. See, it's a mess, very well used. I bought the, it's way, it pays off to buy the larger bottles of pinata inks that you can purchase. I buy from Shades of Clay in Canada. Really great shop. Now, something else that's a handy tip is if you're creating layers and you want a glazed effect, is once you place down your shimmery alcohol ink or your glitter, whatever, as I take the polyurethane, just gently swipe over it to seal it. And once I seal it, I can keep layering more and more and more, and I keep on going like that until I get a lot of texture and a lot of layers. I really like the layered effect where you can see through.
As well with these layers, these are my mini galaxies, and now I just want to share some pictures of my ever-changing fluid galaxy tabletop. I accented what I did with all those nail art powders. You can just check out the videos to find out the process and how many times this tabletop has changed. But the alcohol inks with the mica powder mixed in really added a really nice touch and amplified the colors and created some really cool layers. So feel free to try this on canvases or when it's a non-porous surface or your tabletop, you know. But, and this was over top of polyurethane, so it actually stains the polyurethane depending on how much pigment you have in your ink. Because as you, if you worked with alcohol inks at all, you'll know that some of them have a lot higher pigment. Just like the pinata inks, all of them seem very highly pigmented, which makes them go very far. A little goes a very long way when you dilute it with some alcohol. Rubbing alcohol, of course, that is. Okay, well, thanks a lot for stopping by. I hope you're inspired to try making your own shimmery alcohol inks and save a couple bucks. It's definitely worth checking out the Adirondack Ranger, I'm not sure what to call them, Tim Holtz Pearl inks. They are, I mean, the colors are always beautiful. However, this is just a really cool way to make your own and actually make the base color of mica powder closer to your ink color. So when it, like I said, when it evaporates, you will have a color that is truer to the color of your ink. Unlike, which is a different effect, unlike the Ranger inks where it's like a really pale mica, so you end up with a powdery, shimmery, but powdery pale white surface. All right, have a great day.